Yeah, yeah, we went a lot of different roads, and we found a way.
What ultimately swung it in the third period when it looked like you guys were having so much difficulty scoring a goal and you finally get that one comes out?
Well, I just think what we didn't have in the second period against Boston, I've talked about it quite a bit, is our patience. I thought we just kept on playing. After the first period, I think we had generate 12 or 13 scoring chances, and you can see what the night's going to be like with that goaltender, how well he was playing. So I appreciate our team just trying to stay with it. I think Cam gets a little impatient. He tries to make a tougher play than he needed to. It costs us, but just stayed with it, found a way. Bred scores, a couple of big goals. Zinger, who had a couple of chances prior, scores a goal. So I think it's a good lesson for us as we push forward here, is just stay about yourself and stay with it and not get too antsy about it.
John, just overall, getting into the playoffs for a third consecutive year for this group, what does it mean for you and for this team?
Yeah, it's not about me. It's about them. I'm proud of the guys. Listen, there's been running around our team all year long, right from the get-go, as far as guys leaving. You guys know the story, and there's been a lot of things that have happened within that room. I think the team is held together strong. I think it's been a very honest locker room. When things come up, we air it out right away, so it doesn't sit in the room. So I'm proud of them. I'm not just tonight in finding a way to win in a crazy game, but just how they have handled themselves throughout the year here, as we've gone a little bit of Jekyll and Hyde as we've gone through the year.
I know they eventually tied it up, but Bob's save on Houghton, 2-on-1.
Yeah, he made.
Obviously, Gurriev made a lot of saves, but yeah, it seemed like Bob made maybe 6-7
incredible saves. Yeah, he has found his game for quite a while here now, and it kind of goes unnoticed. You talk about great saves within the 60-minute game, and then the overtime, but then you have breakaways as far as the shooter's concerned. Bob stands in there, makes some saves. So goaltending is a very important part of winning in this league. Bob was a huge part of it tonight.
John, do you think you guys can be a more dangerous team now that you're in? Now that that pressure or weight, if it wasn't there, was there, is off, and you can just go.
We're going to have fun. Play. Yeah, we're going to have fun here. We've been trying to generate that type of attitude. But, you know, we can sit here and talk all we want about you should have fun, don't feel the pressure. They care. Mm-hmm. And they want to get in. And so when you get down to the last two games, I was a little nervous tonight coming into it. I wasn't sure how what the nerves were on the team, but you just kind of get anxious because you want to get in so bad. Mm-hmm. We're there now. Got to play another game tomorrow night. I think it means something, I believe, and haven't even looked that far. I'm going to try to play the right way. We get to the playoffs, we're going to have some fun. We've been through a lot together as a team here. And playoffs is the greatest time of the year, and you better enjoy it. And we're going to try to.
That stuff you mentioned earlier about just all year that they've gone through, you guys have gone through and overcome. Looking forward to the playoffs, that can help you in the playoffs, right? The fact that you guys have overcome that.
Oh, sure. I mean, just the run we've gone on at the end of the year here, when I think people had us dead in the water when we struggled after the deadline. They regrouped, they found themselves, started scoring some goals. All the ups and downs, and it has been, for me, I don't remember all the years, but it's been one of the craziest years for me, especially all the stuff we have to deal with around us in the room, but just the ups and downs as far as our play. Struggle at home, at certain big games we didn't show. A lot of different things happened this year, but when push came to shove towards the end of the year, we went on a run. Guys stepped up and found a way to get in here.
What did you think of the youngster tonight, first game?
Oh, jeez. I think he was probably the calmest one on the bench. I thought he made plays through people, had no fear at all. So you have to look short term, but I also look long term with young kids. We have to. That's an interesting one there, boy, as far as how he handled himself in his first game. Madison Square Garden, under these circumstances, he didn't have a fear at all.
Obviously, Panarin scores the huge goal. But just Savard's play on that, to get in the puck and then the center drive to kind of open up that lane for him.
Yeah.
He's really played well for you down the stretch.
Yeah, he's brought more offense. Savvy has brought more offense to us. And I wasn't sure if he was going to give it to him. I was yelling on the bench to give it to him. It's a pretty good guy to give it to. And Brett makes a great play. You know, I don't think Brett and that all those guys were dead on tonight, but when it came for a big play, we got it. And that's what defines those type of players. And got a huge save from Bob. So I'm happy. I'm happy for the team.
That game was broadcasted in Montreal, and obviously there's a lot of tears right now up there. Do you have a few words for the fans in Montreal?
No.
Thank you.
None.
It was fair? Lots of things happened during the season. You know, I don't want to think over and go over all of this stuff. You know, It was, as I said, it was lots of things were happening behind those doors, and I don't want to talk about. You know, It is what it is. So I'm happy that we are moved to the postseason, and that's I'm looking forward for that.
What was the mood in here after the second period? Obviously, you guys didn't want to go to Ottawa, having to win. What was it like in here, and what was said?
Well, we have to play our game, be patient. That's the key, you know. We don't need to chase. We don't need to force things, you know. Just stay with our game and do our things.
I know you don't like to talk about individual saves, but the save on Howden on the 2-on-1 right before, I mean, can you remember that one?
Yeah, it's just like, you know, in this kind of situation, you have to be locked in. You have to be, like, focused, and because you never know what's going to happen if you let the goal, you know. So you have to be all in, 100, maybe 120%. And you just stay with the moment, be in the moment, and do what's the situation dictate.
How nice was it to get a win like this, you know, despite having a tough one, you know, late in the third period? Had to feel good to come out on top after.
Yeah, I'd rather take 2-on-1, you know, 2-1 win. It's the saved lots of medicine for the hearts, you know. But it is what it is. We get it done in the shootouts, so, and we're happy about that.
When one goes like in like that, I mean, are you just mad at that time? And you're just like, we're going to win this thing?
No, it is what it is again. So if I go back, I would do the same thing. It just happened. So I played the right, I did the right things. It's just what happened. You have to be focused on the next moment and be there and make sure that you are do your best and gives the best possible chance to stop everybody.
You and Artemi have obviously become really good friends since he came here. How nice is it to see, you know, him kind of score those goals and send you guys to the postseason?
Yeah, it's for sure. It's great. So it's a beautiful goal and it's big. So he were big for us. Good goal in the shootout and it's nice.
What is the sense in here right now? Obviously happiness, but is there a sense of relief too?
I think just relief knowing that you're giving yourself a chance to play on and to go for the Stanley Cup. That's why we start the year. So just another opportunity. And I think we made it really interesting in this game, but we've made everything interesting all year. So I'm really proud of the guys for sticking with it after a fluky one and finding a way to get the job done in extra innings.
Was it hard not to get frustrated when you're facing a good goaltender? I mean, you had some great looks, especially in the first period, that didn't go.
Well, I think that's actually what happened to our team. I think we got a little frustrated in the second and allowed their game to get going, and then they get a 1-0 lead because we stopped playing the way we need to, and then we come back in the third and just keep going, and you know it's going to break. I mean, no disrespect, he's a great goalie. He's played well for him, but you get that many great A's or opportunities, you're going to put one past or one or two past them, and we knew it was just a matter of time, so it was nice to get those two in the third and couldn't hold on, but then we, you know, get some good individual efforts. Bob was unbelievable tonight, and then Brad scores some huge ones for us.
Is that a lesson for the playoffs? That because every time you get away from, every time you lose patience, you wind up either losing or almost losing games.
Absolutely. I mean, that is the best message that we can learn from all these games that we played. Is when we stick with it, when we play that style of game, where we get on our forecheck, where we consistently just go at it, no matter what's going on in the game, and react to things the right way. We give ourselves a chance to be a great team and a hard team. And when we don't, it's teams can capitalize. And playoffs, it's no more, it's probably the most magnified. And we are looking forward to kind of rectifying that and making sure we just come into playoffs full guns.
You mentioned this has been a season like no other. There's been all kinds of ups and downs. There's I know there's a million things that we don't even know and you guys do, and that's okay. But just the fact that you know it's going to continue here through all of that, how much tighter does it make this group?
And we're not done. We're not done at all. I think we're a team that feels really confident now that we've gotten in with just everything that we've faced and gone through and grown as a team here together. I think you're just seeing us become more of a team, and we're excited about putting that to use in the playoffs. And whoever we face, however it goes down, we feel confident that we can play with anyone as long as we're playing our game, and it's going to be the battle is getting to our game before another team, and we're really excited about the opportunity.